So it's still incomplete. Remember, this is because we still need to add pilot tones. And so we've got our data stream here. So that's our data. So what we do is, so we send this through an XOR gate and use a pseudo random sequence. So that's a pseudo random sequence here. So with that we guarantee that we are never getting just once into our IFFT, or the chances are very, very low. IFFT. Then we do our bandpass modulator, or so a quadrature modulator. So our bandpass quadrature modulator. And then here we are adding our cyclic prefix. And then once this is added here, we can send this out to our receiver. So that's our transmitter here. And so now let's add our receiver here. So the receiver is our aerial here. So that's our received signal here. That's our transmitted signal here, Rx. So obviously now we have here as the first stage the cyclic prefix detection. So that's the first step. We need to find the start of the symbol. So then we've got our bandpass demodulator. So the bandpass demodulator just creates us our complex signal. And then with that here, we can do our Fourier transform. And as we know, the Fourier transform needs to know exactly the start of the symbol. So that's transmitted here via the detector. So that's the symbol start. So essentially gives us a sample number where the symbol starts and tells the IFFT to do the inverse from that sample. So once we've got our data back in frequency coefficients, we do our XOR operation and we use the same pseudo random sequence again what we used on the transmitter. Pseudo random sequence. Remember, this is exactly the same what we use on the transmitter, otherwise we won't be able to recover anything. And then this is here our data again, which we're getting out here. So that's our data.